Hey YouTube, Origami Man 979 here, and today I'm going to show you a quick tutorial on how to typeset manga. And there's a few different ways. I'm just going to show you the way I do it. There's a few ways to typeset manga. Now, what some people do is they just throw the English text in. Well, I actually have to redraw too. So there's no redrawing on this page, but I'll try to get to a page where I actually have to do some redrawing other than covering the text. So when you open up Photoshop, you're going to start with this tool right here, the move tool. That's just going to be your stock tool. Unless you already have Photoshop open, then it'll be whatever tool you've already selected. First thing you're going to do is press Control Shift N, and you're going to type in edits. Then you're going to hit the M key, then the X key. And you want this down here to be white. That's what the X key does. It switches it from black and white. So X will make it white. Then, since you hit M, you now have your marquee tool, which is your rectangular selection, sorry. And you're just going to select all the text. And by the way, this manga is called Haru Polish. And it's written by, I can't for the life of me remember his name. He wrote the manga Asu no Yoichi, which is another manga I typeset. And I'm typesetting this from Manga Curse Scans. Really good group, in my opinion. But I guess I shouldn't be saying that because I work for them. Bonus points. Okay, once you have all of them selected, make sure you're on the Edits layer. Now, if you created the new layer and titled it Edits, you're going to automatically be on there. Press the G button. It's going to give you the Paint tool. It might give you the Gradient tool. In that case, just click, hold down, select the Paint Bucket tool. Click in the middle of the screen. Then hit X, T, and then hold Control, D. And it's going to deselect, it's going to set you to text, and it's going to change your color back to black. So what you're going to do is, since this is our first bubble, since this is a manga that reads right to left, we're going to go to Word and highlight what we need to put in there. Control, C for copy. And I do not want that, I want Photoshop. Bring us back over to Photoshop. We're just going to highlight an area, and since we have the text tool selected, it's automatically going to throw up our text. And the text I have to use is called Wild Words. This is a $200 font, but you can get it for free if you're really determined. Usually if scanalation groups want you to use it, they will give it to you. Sorry about that noise in the background. I am in my basement. I'm in my basement and we haul our own water, so there's a massive pump room down here. I'm in my basement because I don't want anybody listening to my tutorial while I'm talking, because I embarrass easily. Yes, I embarrass easily. So what? So, once you have Wild Words selected, Roman, which is the standard, there's italic and bold italic, and font size 14, click inside, Control V, it's going to paste it in there. And you want to make sure this is selected. And what that's going to do is it's going to center the text. And also, click your character thing over here, and make sure the two capital T's are selected. That's going to make every letter capitalized. And go along and hit enter a couple times where you need to, just to make sure it's going to line up right, and there's no breakups. Then you can hit enter over on the far right next to all your numbers. But I'm on a laptop, I don't have that enter. If I were to press the enter under backspace, it would just skip down a line instead of exit out of the text. So you gotta come over here, if you're on a laptop like me, you just click that, and it'll exit out of it. Then you press Control G, it's gonna open up a new folder, or you can just press the new folder. And by the way, if you don't wanna press Control Shift N for a new layer, you can always press this right here, this button right there. So double click, rename it text. Click your text layer again, and we're just going to go back and forth, and I'm going to put this in time lapse right now, so you're still going to watch me typeset, but you just won't hear me talking, man. It's going to go really fast. So away to time lapse land. All right, so now that we have this fully typesetted page, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end the tutorial. I know I still have about 5 or so minutes left on a standard YouTube video. I can actually go to 15 minutes, but typesetting takes a lot lo or not typesetting, but redrawing itself takes a lot longer, so I don't think I'm gonna get to that today. Once you're done, you have your text folder with all your text, and you don't have to group them. I do, so that way it stays very organized. You got your background layer. If you want, you can double click that and just rename it BG, and it unlocks the layer so you can do whatever you want with it. And after you got that, you just go to File, Save As, and you go to your folder. It's Chapter 3, and I always create a PSD folder, which is a Photoshop format folder. You open it, it has all my typesetting pages, the ones I've done. Just click OK if that pops up. And then just X out of your page for the time being. Go into your next page. And then you get to start all over. So, that concludes this tutorial. Thanks for watching. If you guys have any questions, feel free to comment, and I will try to get back to you as soon as I can. I do check YouTube quite frequently. I don't know how much I will in the future, but for now, I do check it a lot. If you guys want a tutorial done, send me a PM. And I'll try to make it. I am good with Photoshop, GIMP. Cinema 4D doesn't really work on my computer right now because I had to restore my computer and I can't get it to run right. So I won't be doing any Cinema 4D tutorials, but I can link you guys to tutorials that will help if you do have any questions. Other than that, thanks for watching, comment, subscribe, and